Hi, podcast listeners. It's me, Larry the Cucumber, and it is a beautiful day here on the kitchen countertop. Want to know why? Because I'm here with my BTFF.
Larry, what's a BTFF?
BTFF. Best tomato friend forever.
Best tomato friend for...
That's you. You're my best tomato friend forever.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Larry. Hi, everyone. It's me, Bob the Tomato, and it is a good day here because we have an exciting podcast today. We're talking about courage.
So, I have a question about courage.
Oh, yeah?
Can you be courageous and afraid at the same time?
Good question, Larry. What do you think?
I actually don't know, which is why I was asking you.
Well, maybe we can ask our friends today and see what they think.
Good idea. Today, we'll be talking to Mr. Lunt.
And he'll be talking to a pair of wild mountain lions.
That definitely sounds courageous.
Also, a little bit strange. Courageous, but strange.
Jimmy and Jerry are back with some snacking tips.
We've got a surprise guest.
And our good friend Petunia Rhubarb is doing something super courageous.
Do you know what it is?
She hasn't told me yet, but I can't wait to find out.
Sounds like an exciting... Maybe that's Petunia now.
Petunia, is that you?
Bob? Larry? It's me, Mr. Lunt.
Hey, Mr. Lunt. Are you ready to talk to some mountain lions?
Guys, I'm in major danger. I'm trapped on a bridge over the Colorado River, and I'm cornered by a wild beast. I need your help.
What kind of wild beast?
It's really scary, okay? I need some rescuing. Oh, and some carrots.
Carrots?
Fast!
You got it, Mr. Lunt.
You know what this means, Larry.
You bet I do. We're gonna need a huge butterfly net to catch this beast.
Yeah, sure, but I was gonna say, we're taking this podcast on the road.
Oh yeah, Mr. Lunt, prepare to be rescued. Everybody, we grabbed a bag of carrots from the grocery store, and you'll never believe where we're podcasting from.
Or how fast we're going.
We're in the Larrymobile.
The Larrymobile, as in the supercar that superhero Larry Boy uses.
And it's so fast!
I still can't believe you know a guy who knows a guy who knows Larry Boy, and that he gave you the keys to his ride.
Pretty amazing, right?
If only Larry Boy were here to help us save Mr. Lunt.
I'm sure we can manage. So, who are we talking to first?
Yeah, Petunia. While you drive, I'll dial her up on the Larrymobile's Larry phone.
Hello?
Hi, Petunia. It's Bob and Larry.
And we can't wait to hear what secret, courageous thing you've been up to.
And I can't wait to tell you, because I'm doing it right now. Hold on.
Petunia, are you okay?
Oh, I'm great, guys. I mean, I'm definitely scared and happy and excited and kind of anxious, but I'm having the time of my life.
What in the world are you doing?
You know how I've always been afraid of heights?
I didn't know that.
Well, I am, so I decided to do something about it.
Like, live on the first floor of an apartment building? So you never have to go up the stairs?
No way. I decided to enroll myself in trapeze school.
Trapeze school?
Yep.
Two questions. First, is trapeze school even real? And second, why? Trapeze artists swing really high in the air. That sounds terrifying.
Trapeze school is a real thing. I even have a great teacher. And why would I do it? Well, I figured the best way to beat my fears is to face them. Like this. I know you guys can't see me, but I'm about to do a huge flip. 1, 2, 3! Woo!
That definitely sounded amazing.
And it feels amazing. But don't do this at home. You've got to have a great teacher.
Aren't you afraid, though?
You bet I am.
So, Petunia, do you think someone can be afraid and courageous at the same time?
Of course. Being courageous doesn't mean I'm not scared. It just means I'm not gonna let my fear stop me.
Wow. In that case, I think you have more courage than anyone I know.
Thanks, Bob. Well, I better let you go. I'm working on my double backflip where I catch the other trapeze bar in midair. Here goes!
Bye, Petunia!
See you later, Bob and Larry!
Now that is amazing! Bob, do you have a big fear that you'd like to beat?
Well, I don't know.
Are you sure you don't know it right off the top of your head?
Oh, look, it's time for snack tips with Jimmy and Jerry Gord. Just gotta dial their number.
Hello, you have reached the voicemail box of Jimmy and Jerry Gord. We can't come to the phone right now because we're probably eating and or snacking, and we've been told it's rude to speak with our mouths full of food while we chew. So, yeah.
Jimmy? Jerry? It's Bob and Larry.
Hey, that rhymes.
Yes, I know, Larry. Anyway, just call us when...
Bob and Larry! It's Jimmy and Jerry!
That rhymes too, Bob!
Sorry, we were away from the phone.
Snacking? Yeah, we know.
Nope. Actually, this time we were buying snacks. Right, Jerry?
Right!
So, what kind of snacking tips do you guys have for us today?
Yeah, we love a good snacking tip.
Today we will tell you how to clean your car with a tater tot snack.
Oh, you're serious?
We don't joke about snacks.
Okay, tell us how it's done, guys.
The first step to a tater tot car wash is to buy tater tots. Thankfully, that's where Barbara comes in.
Who's Barbara?
I'm Barbara. Barbara Buck. I bought the tater tots so them Gords could clean my truck.
Bob, another rhyme.
I really don't know what to say.
Step two, waterproof your tater tot.
Waterproof the tot.
How in the world do you waterproof a tater tot?
Tater tot spray.
Tater tot spray?
Yeah, it comes in big purple cans at your local tater tot shop.
This is amazing.
And now for the third and final step. Wash your car with the tot. Just rub it over every surface till it shines.
And how is your truck looking now, Barbara?
I'm not gonna lie to you, Mr. Cucumber. My truck has never looked shinier. Although, it is quite greasy.
Now, I'm no expert, but the grease from the tot might actually make your truck more aerodynamic.
Amazing!
Unbelievable!
Now, how do we remove the grease?
With a banana.
But I didn't buy any bananas.
No bananas.
Tune in next week for Snack Time with Jimmy and Jerry Gord, where we degrease a truck with a banana. Goodbye!
Bye!
So, Larry, do you think Larry Boy would want us to clean the Larrymobile with a tater tot?
I doubt it, Bob, but maybe we can ask him.
So, how far away are we from Mr. Lunt?
We're getting closer. Only a few minutes away now. Hang in there, Mr. Lunt. We're coming to rescue you.
Larry, I think we're getting a call from a real-life kid.
Yes, my favorite part of the show.
Hello, and welcome to the Veggie Tales Podcast. Bob and Larry here.
Live from the Larrymobile.
Wow, I wish I was in the Larrymobile.
It is pretty awesome.
So what's your name, and what can we do for you today?
My name's Hannah, and, well, I really want to ride my bike without training wheels.
But you don't know how to take them off?
No, it's not that. I'm just scared to do it.
Riding your bike without training wheels is a big step, Hannah.
Yeah, the first time I tried, I fell and I scraped my knee.
Hannah, we're all scared of something.
Yeah, right. What are you guys afraid of?
Snakes at the zoo. I know they can't come out of their glass houses, but sometimes I think, what if they do? And that's when I start running so the imaginary snake doesn't eat me. What about you, Bob?
Well, to be honest...
It's okay, Bob. You can tell us.
I've always been a little afraid of riding my bike without training wheels, too.
Really? I thought I was the only one.
I tried it once, fell off, and just decided to never ride a bike again.
Never again?
I'm probably just more of a roller skating guy.
I think we can all learn some valuable lessons here.
Like what?
For starters, always wear knee pads and a helmet.
I have those, but they don't make me feel braver.
Lesson number two. You're not alone. Everyone is afraid of something.
Like you and me, Bob.
I guess so.
And you know what else? God is always with you, no matter what. Bob, who's that guy in the Bible? The guy who was friends with Moses?
You mean Joshua?
That's the one. And didn't God have a special message for him?
He sure did. Just as the children of Israel were about to enter a scary new land, God told Joshua, "Don't be afraid. Don't be discouraged. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go."
Yeah, and I bet they were super afraid. But God told them he would always be with them no matter what.
Guys, I'm putting the phone in my bike basket, and I'm gonna do this.
Are you still afraid, Hannah?
A lot afraid, but I'm gonna do it anyway.
Now that's being courageous.
Here goes. I don't know about this. I think I got it. Thanks, Bob and Larry. You're the best.
Way to go, Hannah.
Way to be courageous.
Talk to you later.
Bye. Isn't that the best?
I love helping real kids.
Same, Bob. Same. So, Bob, do you think you're ready to ride a bike without training wheels now?
We'll be back after a quick word from our sponsor.
Are your muscles kind of droopy? Is your brain a little loopy? When you see a supervillain, does your courage go bloopy? Here's a little secret that'll set you right. Drink 7-fold glasses of Vegemite.
Hey, kids, who wants to be a superhero?
I want to be a superhero.
Then you need Vegemite, the natural, veggie-powered super supplement for superheroes like Larry Boy.
Will Vegemite really give me superpowers?
Let me put it this way, kids. It Vegemite make you strong enough to lift a dump truck. It Vegemite make you faster than a cheetah. And it Vegemite have the occasional side effect like growing an extra toe on the backside of your earlobe, which is basically like another superpower.
Cool. Are you serious?
Remember, kids,
I said Mike.
As a mom, I know how hard it can be to get my kids to eat nutritious foods. That's why Vegemite comes in 3 delicious flavors your kids are going to love. Tree bark, fish guts, and raspberry turtle toe.
Ew, yeah, love.
Don't knock it till you've tried it, kids. Remember, if you want to go from super zero
to super duper hero,
try Vegemite today.
Are your muscles kind of droopy? Is your brain a little loopy? When you see a supervillain, does your courage go bloopy? Here's a little secret that'll set you right. Drink 7-fold glasses of Vegemite.
Now in fish gut flavor.
Hello, this is Bob.
How far away are you guys? I don't know how long I can make it on this bridge.
We're in the Larrymobile, Mr. Lunt, and we're coming as fast as we can.
Make it even faster. I'm terrified of this creature that's staring me down.
How fast does this thing go?
Let's find out.
Whoa! Larry, this is fast. Probably too fast. Oh, no. Is something wrong?
No, Bob. That's just a surprise guest alarm.
Oh, yeah. I'm excited for our special guest. He is out of this world. Hello, this is Bob and Larry, live from the Larrymobile. And you must be our special guest, Glenn John.
Hi, Bob and Larry. Sure is great to be joining you on your podcast. You might hear a little static. I'm calling from Space Station Zebra.
Space Station Zebra? Like outer space? For real?
It's true. I'm looking out the window at Earth right now, and you are a very, very small dot from up here.
You're an astronaut? Wow! Are there meteors flying around up in space?
Larry, hold on. Let's give Glenn some time to talk. Can you tell us, is it scary up in space?
Well, there is some scariness in going to places unknown, like space. But I'm not alone. There's a whole team behind me, and all of us on the team have studied and prepared for this for years. But just like Joshua, when he was preparing to enter the Promised Land, he first had to put his complete trust in God for the courage to go into the unknown. That's what I do every day up in space.
Excuse me, Glenn John, but we're going to have to let you go now. We're getting close to saving our friend, Mr. Lunt.
Thanks for having me, guys. Stay safe out there.
The road ends here, but according to my map, we're still 3 miles away.
That's a long way to run.
Not if we take the Larry bikes, which are right here in the trunk.
Larry bikes? How do you know so much about Larry Boy's gear?
Just a hunch, I guess.
Oh, but Larry, I don't ride bikes, remember?
You do with a little bit of courage.
Yeah, but...
Remember what you told Hannah. You can do this, even if you're a bit afraid of trying it again. And why?
Because God is always with me. Okay, here goes. Steady. Whoa! Ah!
You can do this, Bob. Courage!
I'm doing it! I'm doing it!
Podcast listeners, I wish you could see what I'm seeing. Bob riding a bike! We'll cut to one of our favorite songs as we ride to save our friend Mr. Lunt.
They're big, I'm little. They go, I twiddle. Why can't little guys do big things too?
You're not going to sing, are you? Couldn't you just play your harp and I'll throw things at you? Oh. What you're saying? All right, I understand. Now let's suppose that this is true. You still look rather wimpy, but I know what we can do. Just step behind this curtain. It will only take a minute. There's a closet in the corner, and you'll like what I've got in it. You'll find my royal armor there. Now, Danny, put it on. Yes, now you'll look much bigger when the battle lines are drawn. One more thing you'll need, I think. Pick up my royal sword. It's a big one and a beauty. The best we could afford. Once you've got it all together, I think you will agree. You're bound to do much better if you try to look like me. Oh, dear.
You know, I think maybe I should just be plain old me.
Oh, yes. Well, I suppose. But have you seen Goliath? Why, he's...
He's big, but God's bigger. And when I think of him, that's when I figure.
With his help, little guys can do big things.
With his help, I know I can do big things.
With his help, little guys can do big things, too.
Into. Oh dear.
Welcome back, podcast listeners.
We've almost reached the bridge where our friend, Mr. Lunt, is stuck.
There. I see the bridge.
Mr. Lunt, are you there?
Help!
We're coming for you, and we brought you that bag of carrots.
Mr. Lunt!
I'm over here!
I thought you said you were trapped by a wild beast.
Yeah, I don't see anything.
It's right there!
It's a jackalope!
A jackalope?
A vicious bunny rabbit with antlers!
But jackalopes aren't even real.
Nor scary.
But that does kind of look like a jackalope, I guess.
Hold up! You were gonna talk to mountain lions, but you're afraid of a cute little rabbit?
I never said it was a rational fear. It's just my greatest fear.
Tell him, Bob.
Mr. Lunt, you might feel afraid, but you can still be courageous. Here, catch this bag of carrots. Now feed that jackalope some carrots, and he'll be on his way.
But I don't feel courageous.
We're here with you, Mr. Lunt. And no matter what you're afraid of, God is always with you, too.
Just feed the jackalope some carrots. Here, jackalope. Here you go, boy. Please don't eat my fingers or toes or my mustache. I really like my mustache. Oh, no. Oh, no. He's running for me. I can't do this.
He doesn't want your mustache. He just wants the carrot.
Guys, it's working. I'm doing it.
Hey, that's not a jackalope.
Guys, these aren't antlers. This cute little bunny got a pretzel stuck on his head. My bad. I hope you guys didn't go to too much trouble to rescue me.
You've got to be kidding me.
I think I'll keep him as a pet. Wanna pet him?
Oh, do I? Sweet little rabbit.
Oh, no!
He took my keys!
To the Larrymobile!
Quick, catch that rabbit!
Get back here, you!
Well, that's all for today, folks. Thanks for listening to the podcast.
Remember, kids, never trust a rabbit! I was gonna say, God made you special.
And he loves you very much.
Goodbye.
Be courageous. Catch you later.